Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in this video I am going to discuss some important questions, some numericals from the topic of variance analysis. So you know, in SEBI grade A examination in paper 2 you have 6 subjects, and costing or cost accounting is one of those 6 subjects. So in costing you have the topic of standard costing and variance analysis, so you can expect numerical questions from variance analysis in the examination. So friends, do participate and actively post your answers in the chat box, okay, so that you can benefit from this session. So if you are still not subscribed to our channel, then do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular notifications and updates. Also you can join our Telegram group to get the benefit. Now let us start with the first question without wasting any time. So the question says, product A requires 10 kg of material at the rate of rupees 4 per kg. Okay. The actual consumption of material for manufacturing product A comes to 12 kg of material at the rate of rupees 4.5 per kg. So you have to calculate the material usage variance. Okay. So solve this question and post your answer in the chat box. So the options are, option A, rupees 6 adverse, option B, rupees 8 adverse, option C, rupees 14 adverse, option D, rupees 6 favorable, or is it option E, rupees 8 favorable. So these are the options for you. So you have to calculate material usage variance, okay? So you know there is material cost variance, there is material price variance, and there is material usage variance. And material cost variance is the summation of material price variance and material usage variance. So in this question, the information which is given to you is that for producing product A, 10 kg of material is required. So standard quantity is equal to 10 kg and standard price is given to you as rupees 4 per kg. Right, then actual consumption of the material for manufacturing product A comes out to be 12 kg. So actual quantity of the material comes out to be 12 kg and actual price comes out to be rupees 4.5 per kg. So these are the four information which you is given in the question. Now you can easily calculate the material usage variance. So what is the formula of material usage variance? The formula is standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. This is the formula. So now standard quantity is 10. Actual quantity is given to you as 12. Okay. And what is the standard price? Standard price is given to you as rupees 4 per kg. So minus 2 multiplied by 4 comes out to be minus 8. So minus sign indicates that this is adverse variance, okay, or unfavorable. So rupees 8 adverse, which is option B, is the correct answer for this question. I hope this is very clear to you. Now we can proceed to the next question. So question 2, it says A Limited used 4538 kg of material at a standard cost of rupees 2.5 per kg. Okay, the material usage variance was rupees 280 and the variance was favorable. You have to calculate the standard usage of material. Okay, so the options given to you are option A, 4700 kg, option B, 4650 kg, option C, 4600 kg, or is it option D, 4588 kg. Okay, so you have to calculate the standard usage of material. So what is the information being given to you? So standard cost or standard price of the material is given to you as rupees 2.5 per kg, and quantity, actual quantity of material is given to you. So actual quantity of material consumed is given to you as 4538 kg. This is the information. And apart from that, you are being given that the material usage variance, material usage variance is rupees 280, and since this is favorable, so it will be a positive figure. Okay, so what is the formula of material usage variance? The formula says standard quantity minus actual quantity multiplied by standard price. This is the formula. So you have to just substitute the values, okay, and you will get the remaining value. So material usage variance is given to us as rupees 280. Standard quantity or standard usage we have to calculate. Actual quantity is given to us as 4538, and standard price is given to us as 2.5. Now if you take 2.5 to the other side, so we have to divide 280 by 2.5, which will be equal to standard quantity minus actual quantity, which is 4538. Okay, so this will come out to be 112 is equal to standard quantity minus 4538. So standard quantity, it will come out to be, if you add this up, it will come out to be 4650. This will come out to be rupees 4650 kgs, not rupees. This will come out to be 4650 kgs. So the correct answer will be option B, 4650 kgs. This is the standard quantity of material. Okay, actual quantity we were given, we have to calculate the standard quantity. Okay, I hope this is very, very clear. Now moving on to the next question, question 3. So the question says, during a period 17,500 labor hours were worked at a standard cost of rupees 6.5 per hour. Okay, the labor efficiency variance is rupees 7,800 favorable. How many standard hours were produced? So this is the question from labor variance. You have material variance, you have labor variance, okay, you have overhead variance. Okay, so you are given 17,500 labor hours, they were worked at a material cost of rupees 6.50 per hour. Labor efficiency variance is given to you as 7,800 favorable. You have to calculate the standard hours. Now options are, option A 1,200, option B 18,700, option C 17,500, or is it option D 16,300. Okay, so guys, solve this question and post your answer in the chat box. So let me write down the information which is being given. So the standard cost or the standard price of labor per hour is given to you as 6.5 per hour. Okay, then 17,500 labor hours were worked, which means actual quantity or actual hours are given to you as 17,500. Okay, apart from that, you are given labor efficiency variance as 7,800 and it is favorable. You have to calculate the standard hours. Okay, standard hours is what you need to calculate. Okay, so labor variance or labor cost variance is basically a summation of labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance. Okay, so in this question we are being given labor efficiency variance. So what is the formula of labor efficiency variance? The formula says standard hours minus actual hours, okay, multiplied by the standard price. This is the formula of labor efficiency variance. Now you simply need to substitute the values in this formula. Okay, so labor efficiency variance is given to us as 7,800. Standard hours we need to calculate. Actual hours are given to us as 17,500, right? And standard price is given to us as 6.5. So we will take 6.5 to the other side. So 7,800 divided by 6.5 is equal to standard hours minus 17,500. I hope up till here there is no problem. So let me write on the upper side of the slide. So now if you divide 7,800 by 6.5, so you will get, let me do this, you will get here 1200. Okay, so on the left hand side you will get 1200, and on the right hand side you have standard hours minus 17,500. So standard hours, it will come out to be 18,700 hours. So standard hours are 18,700, which is option B. I hope this question is very, very clear to you. So this was from labor efficiency variance. Okay. Now moving on to the next question, question number 4. So the question says the standard hourly rate was rupees 1.40. The actual rate was rupees 1.30. The labor rate variance is given to you as rupees 600 favorable. You have to calculate the actual labor hours. Okay. So the options given to you are option A, 6000 hours. Option B, 6400 hours. Option C, 1000. Option D, 1500. Or is it option E, 5000? Okay. So this is a question regarding labor rate variance. So I told you labor cost variance is a summation of labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance. So let me write down the information for you. So standard price is given to you as rupees 1.40 per hour, and actual price is given to you, actual price, or you can say actual rate is given to you as rupees 1.30 per hour. Okay. Labor rate variance is given to you as rupees 600 and it is favorable, so it is a positive figure. You have to calculate the actual labor hours. Okay, this you need to calculate. So what is the formula to calculate labor rate variance? The formula to calculate labor rate variance is simply standard price minus actual price multiplied by the actual hours. This is the formula. Now simply you need to substitute the values in this formula. So 600 is equal to 1.4 minus 1.3 multiplied by the actual hours. Okay. So this will be 600 is equal to 0.1 into actual hours. So actual hours, it will come out to be 6000. Okay. So actual labor hours, they come out to be 6000 hours. I hope this is very, very clear. So option A would be the correct answer for this question. Okay, guys. Now moving on to the final question for the day. So the question says, if standard hours are 400 at the rate of rupees 1 per hour and actual hours are 380 at the rate of rupees 1.5 per hour, you have to calculate the labor rate variance. Okay. So the options given to you are option A, rupees 20 favorable. Option B, rupees 25 favorable. Or is it option C, rupees 100 adverse. Or option D, rupees 190 adverse. These are the four options given to you. And the information which is being given to you is standard hours are given as 400. Standard price or standard rate is given to you as rupees 1 per hour. Actual hours is given to you as 380. And actual rate or actual price is given to you as 1.5. Okay. You need to calculate the labor rate variance. So I told you labor rate variance is equal to standard rate or standard price minus actual rate. Okay. Multiplied by the actual hours. So simply you can solve this now. 1 minus 1.5 multiplied by the actual hours, which is 380. So this will be minus 0.5 multiplied by 380. So this is 380. So this will be minus 190. So minus means this is adverse. Okay. So labor rate variance comes out to be rupees 190 adverse, which is option D. So I hope this is clear to you. So we have discussed labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance both. Okay. So I hope, guys, you must have liked this video. So do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular notifications and updates. And if you have any query or doubt, you can always ask in the comment section below. All the very best for your examination. Have a nice day.